You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Friday, March 13th, 2020. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we have been talking about the vice of envy and the remedy to this vice, which is loving pity. We have seen this played out through the story of the selfish giant. Yesterday, we looked at the first of the two thieves that were crucified with Jesus, the bad thief, or the thief that chose envy and criticism. Today, we are going to look at the good thief, or the repentant thief, as he's sometimes called. Now, let's just review once again. Two men were crucified with Jesus Christ. We don't know from the gospel exactly what they were guilty of. And remember, they were probably also Jews. At the time, the Roman Empire controlled Jerusalem. Remember, Pontius Pilate was a Roman. And to keep the order, they used brutal force, meaning they oftentimes crucified or did even worse things to people so that they could control the Jewish people. So these two men were probably Jewish, but we can understand that they likely did something terrible. Maybe they were thieves. Maybe they were working to do all sorts of terrible things. Maybe they were murderers. We have no idea, but we can understand that they did something bad. Jesus, on the other hand, of course, is completely innocent. So they're crucified. And we also know that when a person is crucified, they do not die right away. The Romans were experts at being brutally torturous to people. When a person was crucified, it often took hours and hours for them to die. In fact, we read later in the gospel that the Romans ordered that the legs be broken of those that were crucified so that they would die faster. So the men are up there hanging on the crosses for a long time. We also hear that some of the high priests come by and they mock Jesus, just like the unrepentant thief, the bad thief, mocks him and says, "I thought you were God. Then come off of that cross if you are." The high priests also choose envy and they say the same thing to Jesus. But there's one man in this whole situation that chooses something radically different. He chooses pity. While they are hanging there, the good thief says to Jesus, he says, "Remember me when you come into your kingdom." Now, that might seem like a very tiny little phrase that can't be that big, but it is. Let's look at it for a second. "Remember me when you come into your kingdom." Now, this essentially is saying, first of all, he acknowledges that Jesus is God. He's not trapped inside of his own little pain party, but he can look out and see Jesus with open eyes, and he can acknowledge that Jesus is God. If he's coming into his kingdom, even after he's dead, then there's some sort of, he must have some sort of divine heavenly kingdom. Also, he throws himself at the feet of Jesus. He says, "Remember me," meaning, "Think on me with love and pity. Remember that I believed even at this final moment of my life." And of course, we know that Jesus responds to this man. He doesn't respond to the criticism and the jeering of the bad thief or even the high priest, but he does take a second to respond to the good thief. He says, "Truly I say to you, today you will be with me in paradise." So he says, "You're going to come to heaven with me." Now, this is so remarkable because remember, this man was not innocent, but this teaches us that with God, love really is blind. Now, I'm not saying that God doesn't see you and know you. I'm not saying that at all. What I'm saying instead is that when we love God and we love other people without worrying about who's better or who's worse, but we just love them, then God chooses to be blind to all of our sins. He looks at the good thief who maybe had lived a terribly sinful, horrible life up to this moment. And all he sees is the loving pity that he is offering Jesus as he dies on the cross. That's it. But my friends, that's enough. That's enough. And even though he did so many horrible things in his life, the good thief goes to heaven. And so, my friends, this is the lesson to learn from the selfish giant and from the two men that died on the cross next to Jesus, that we need to choose love. When someone is better than us or worse than us, we need to look at them, not worry about our own problems or our own situation, but look at them and decide that I'm going to love you and see you and not worry about my own mess, but love you. That is what Jesus teaches us from the cross. And so, Sprouts, my challenge for you today is to look at a crucifix and simply pray that you can respond with pity, that you can look upon Jesus or upon anyone in your life that is suffering and choose pity.
That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow, but until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be.
Hey there, I hope that you're having a beautiful and holy Lent. I ask simply that as we prepare for Easter, you think about other people that you can share this podcast with so that they too can have the resources to grow in the love of Jesus Christ through the knowledge of his beautiful church.